Hey guys, it's Abby here again with NLC Live. So glad that you're joining us again today. I'm going to be wrapping up our finance series for the week. So happy Friday, and let's dive right in. So we are in the book of Luke today, Luke chapter 12, verse 15. So I'm going to give you just a little bit of context about what's going on in this story. So this is, we're in the Gospels right now. Jesus is in the peak of his ministry. He is going around, he's healing people, he's raising people from the dead, he's telling parables, he's performing miracles. There's like a lot going on right now, and he is busy. And while he walks around, there are people that will call out to him. Someone out in the crowd said, "Teacher, order my brother to give me a fair share of the family inheritance." He replied, "Mister, what makes you think it's any of my business to be a judge or mediator for you?" Speaking to the people, he went on, "Take care, protect yourself against the least bit of greed. Life is not defined by what you have, even when you have a lot." So I don't know about you, but this story is kind of funny to me. It's like Jesus is doing all of these things, and then you have this one guy. Like, if I was there, if I was one of those people that was following him around, you know, wanting healing or something, and then this guy like pops in and is like, "Actually, sir, can you please tell my brother to give me my fair share?" It's like, who invited this guy? I'm trying to get healed, and you want him to come settle like some family drama here? No, I'd be like, go home and you figure that out on your own. Jesus is busy. So in this story, Jesus sees straight through this man's question. This man was trying to make it about something right and wrong. Like, come be the judge of this, come be the mediator here. And Jesus says, "I don't need to do that for you." He can see straight through that question, and he knows that greed is really at the heart of it. I think that's the command to obey right off the bat. Take care, protect yourself. Some versions even say, be on guard. And when I hear the word guard, it makes me think about Proverbs 4, verse 23. It says, "Above all else, guard your heart, for everything you do flows from it." And usually when we talk about this verse, I hear it a lot when we talk about dating, relationships, like what we watch on TV. But what about greed? Are we guarding ourselves from a spirit of greed? Or when it creeps in, do we just let it in? Do we just let those feelings of discontentment take over? Because I don't know about you, but for me, anytime I'm experiencing this kind of spirit, it's very like, it really does creep in. I don't realize it's happening until one day I look around and I'm like, "Oh, I want this. I need more stuff." I'm all of a sudden like discontent with what I have. Things that months ago I was extremely grateful for and knew that this was like a blessing from the Lord. All of a sudden I'm like, "Ah." So there's nothing wrong with wanting good things in our life. There's nothing wrong with advancing our family, providing for our families, blessing others. That's a good thing. Those are good things. But I think the scripture does a really good job of getting to the heart of the issue and what might be behind any of those motivations. Promise to claim. So I think the promise to claim here is pretty clear also. It says, "Life is not defined by what you have, even when you have a lot." So I heard someone say one time that men and women, people in general, they make really crummy gods. They cannot bear the weight of all of our expectations, all of our hope. Ecclesiastes says that God has set eternity in the heart of men, meaning literally that all of these things, there's no way they could satisfy us. There's no way they could complete us. So the application to make is, are we grateful? A question that I like to ask myself often, just to keep in that spirit of contentment, is, if God never blessed me with any other material thing or spiritual blessing, would I still be content with what He's given me today, which is salvation, my family, all the things that He's done in my life up until this point? Like, would I be satisfied with just Jesus, with what He's given me, with what He's done in my life? Would that be enough? And I'll say too, I'm not here to tell you how to spend your money, what to spend your money on. What I'm asking is, are you walking through life with a spirit of contentment, or are you constantly wanting more because you think that's what will satisfy? Because the scriptures are super clear, you're not going to be defined by what you have. And God does give us everything for our enjoyment, but when we start to enjoy the blessings more than the blesser, that's when things can get really mixed up. Let's pray. God, thank you for this day. Thank you for all the people that are watching. God, I just pray that you would just give us that spirit of contentment. Anytime we feel greed creeping in, God, that you would remind us of all that you've done for us, every spiritual blessing, every physical blessing you've given us. Lord, we know that all of those things come from you because you're a good, good Father. God, we're thankful that we're not defined by what we have, but that we're defined by what your Son did on the cross. Lord, we praise you for this and we thank you. We pray that you'd give us a good rest of the day. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Thanks, guys, and we'll see you next week.